Good afternoon. Many thanks for staying with us. My name is Akisa Wandera. Let's start with that ugly scenes in schools. Secondary schools heads are ruling out the possibility of exam cheating as the reason for the ongoing school unrest. Speaking during a crisis meeting at the Kenya Institute of Curriculum Development in Nairobi, the heads said some of the schools where the destruction of property have taken place have not had a history of cheating in exams. They further appealed to parents to take up the challenge of disciplining their children. Let's hear what they had to say.
That we are using this general expression about the lack of confidence.
As you have heard, this is a special meeting that we are holding between the Teacher Service Commission, who are the employers of the teachers, and the Kenya Secondary School Heads Association. Mainly, we do hold these type of meetings even when there is no crisis. But this one seems to coincide with the current student unrest in our schools. And the purpose of today's meeting is really to be able to talk to each other, to engage, and to address the current situation in our schools. You all agree with us that it's a national issue, and therefore we have taken it to be very, very serious. But on the onset, as an employer, for the teachers. I wish to thank the head teachers most sincerely, and the teachers in our schools. They do a wonderful job because we leave children with them. They stay with the children longer than even the parents. And we believe that they do a very good job because in most cases, they look after those children under even very difficult circumstances. In boarding schools, for example, they work for very long hours, even into the night, and we do appreciate their work. And we want to encourage them and tell them that we support them as they move forward to handle these issues. But on the current situation, it's not a blame game on our part. As the employer of teachers, we are not saying that anybody is really to blame for what is happening. What we are looking for are solutions. And we are appealing to all the stakeholders in this country in matters of education so that we can give our support to schools to ensure that issues of student unrest are addressed once and for all. And we know the stakeholders are many. We have a special message for the parents. We need special support from the parents so that the children can hear positive messages, even from home. We also appeal for support from the school communities, from boards of management. And as a country, we need to give our learners a sense of existence. We want to encourage them. We tell them that there is hope so that issues of unrest can be handled in a special way. And even the students who are listening to us, we want to appeal to them that when there are problems, problems have to be sorted out through dialogue. That's why we have student councils in schools, and they can't be handled in a violent manner. It is through dialogue that conflicts can be solved. So we also appeal to you as the Land Estate members so that we address issues knowing that this is our country. We don't need to set it on fire. We need to support our country because it belongs to us. Thank you very much indeed.
We are grateful to our Employer Teacher Service Commission that has convened this important meeting so that we share on this issue that is affecting the education sector currently. Here in the discussion, we have what we call National Governing Council that is composed of chairpersons of KESHA from every county in the country. And we also have the National Executive Committee members of KESHA. And together with the TSC, we are now able to look at and we are getting reports of the concern from every county. And I believe by the end of our meeting today, we'll be able to give you some of the way forward, the way we would want this to be happening. But we are hopeful that after this meeting, we hope the country is watching and the children are watching, because we'd want this issue of burning of the dormitories in this country to stop, so that we embark on normal teaching and learning for our children, because currently, as we are talking now, the most important thing is the preparation for the exams, which is just about to take place in the next two months. And would want the children to understand the concern which every stakeholder has on their welfare. And I believe from what we are discussing, we are able now to advise on how we go along as we move forward. We are realizing that the unrest in school, the children are concentrating on the dormitories. And this is an area that we would want to emphasize. Why is it the dormitories and not any other physical facility within the school? The classrooms, the administration blocks, the laboratories and learning points are very safe. They seem to be concentrating here. And I think the children are maybe passing a message that there could be a problem on the boarding side of. And if you look at the statistics, most of those burning that are taking place are in the boarding schools. The day schools, if they are there, they may be very few at all. So this one here is guiding our deliberation here, so that we can advise the government on some of the complaints that the children have in the boarding wing. And we hope at the end of the day we'll have something tangible to share, so that you can pass it over to the public. Thank you.
Mr. Awiti, could there be burning?
Excuse me. I just wanted to know.
Well, our reporter Murimi Mwange has been keeping tabs on that those particular developments on the school fires. He also attended that particular meeting, crisis meeting, by the head teachers or the school heads. Let's now link up with our reporter Murimi Mwange, who is joining us from our city center studios for more updates on what really was said in this particular meeting. Good afternoon, Murimi. Many thanks for joining us on News Desk. So since the school heads are ruling out the possibility of exam cheating as the reason for the school fires, what exactly are they attributing this particular situation to?
Good afternoon, Akisa. Of course, the issue of examination cheating and the recent rules that were introduced by the ministry to curb examination cheating has been cited as one of the possible factors that might have been behind the wave of unrest in schools. But of course, when we spoke to the officials from the TSC and the Head Teachers Association, their feedback was that that might be one of the reasons cited, but there needs to be a little bit more interaction between all the stakeholders in matters education. And that's why he's talking of parents also now coming into the conversation, because most of the schools that have been affected are those that are boarding schools, and therefore the argument is that perhaps it's the high time that the stakeholders in the education sector focus more keenly on what could be the challenges that are facing students in boarding schools, and perhaps that would form a conversation in the future about how to fight the unrest in schools. But of course, there have been also reports that it could be a fight back by people or forces that are against the radical measures that have been introduced by the ministry on the education sector. But of course, the Head Teachers Association representatives that were there did not want to confirm or deny reports, having gotten any reports from head teachers complaining about the radical measures. But of course, that's also going to be part of the longer conversation now between the stakeholders in matters education, and that's where they're insisting that a critical stakeholder that needs to be brought into that conversation are the parents that are also key to instilling discipline in their children. Akisa.
Well, Murimi, and even as they talk about roping in stakeholders like parents into the students' conversation and the education sector in its entirety, what are some of the possible long-term or short-term solutions that have been suggested in this particular meeting?
Now, part of the solutions that have been brought forward include the closure of schools early enough, but of course the teachers and the TSC vehemently objected to that. Even the ministry itself said that doing so would be a postponement of the crisis and it might come to explode in the future. In fact, the Head Teachers Association was saying that sending the students home now might be a crisis, a bigger crisis in waiting, because once they come back from home, they might engage in more unrest. And of course, third term is critical to the education calendar. And therefore, they're saying that aside from that, the most important thing for them to do now is to have that conversation that brings together not only the key top stakeholders in education, from the ministry to the TSC and the teachers unions, but now even the students and their parents. And of course that means that in the future perhaps we might see similar consultative meetings between even officials from the PTA as well as the BOGs from the affected schools. Akisa.
All right, thank you very much for that, Murimi. Rimi Mwangi, our reporter, following up the developments on the wave of the school unrest in the country for weeks now. And Rimi is joining us from our city center studios. But still on that, seven students have been arrested in connection to a fire incident at St. Patrick's School in Iten. A dormitory was torched at the school last night. St. Patrick's is one of the five schools whose dormitories were burnt to the ground last night. Dome 10 at the St. Patrick's used to accommodate 88 students. The dormitory was donated to the school in 1985, and the school principal, Wilson Yego, says the incident is a suspected arson attack. County Commissioner Frederick Ndambuki, who was at the scene, confirmed that the administration has taken over security of the school. Elgeyo Marakwet Governor Alex Stolgos said the incident is unfortunate to happen to a national school that has consistently performed excellently. The governor, who is also an old boy of the school, said his government will offer necessary support to ensure learning continues uninterrupted. The school administration and stakeholders are convening today to deliberate on the way forward.
Was raised down by fire, which we suspect that it was burned by a student. It is quite unfortunate that this had to happen in St. Patrick's. The students have been calm the whole of last week. Till on Sunday I left to Nairobi to seek approval for a dormitory we want to build. I had just arrived at 7:30, the school gate is when I had commotion in one of the classes. So I parked outside the gate and rushed in to find out what was happening. I found teachers and students trying to put off the fire. A quick inquiry shows that somebody was seen rushing out of the dormitory with his head covered. And jumped over the fence. Students tried to chase, but he was too fast for the students. I want to take this opportunity to thank the members of the public, thank the area leadership, for the massive support we received. Everybody came in to join the students and the teachers in putting up the fire.
As a leader in education in the county, I want to say that we had not heard of any incident of unrestness in the school. The school has been calm. In fact, today my officers were here having a function with the heads of primary schools from KU South and KU. So nothing unusual was seen by day. So I want to say we are disappointed with this incident, and we may not know to whom to attribute the problem, but we'll carry out investigation as an office. We'll be able to communicate.
I want to ask all to remain very calm as we go over this. There's no cause of alarm, and we'll take charge of every aspect of our lives and properties, as it were, in Elgeyo Marakwet. So remain very vigilant to all our secondary schools. We will be able to ensure the safety of all our students and every other property in every given school in Elgeyo Marakwet.
And as that happened in St. Patrick's Iten, in Nyeri, the students of Akeni Girls have made a second attempt in a week to burn their school. Let's now bring in our reporter, Carol Nderi, live from our Nyeri Bureau with those details. Good afternoon, Carol. Many thanks for joining us. A second attempt here by the girls in Akeni to burn their schools. What is the situation right now?
A good afternoon to you, Akisa. Yes, we're coming live to you from Nyeri County. A point of correction, the second attempt is at Yakai Bay Boys High School in Madera East in Nyeri County. Just a few days ago, a dormitory went up in flames, and yesterday night, another dormitory went up in flames. Initially, the students had been sent home after the first incident, but the Form 4s had requested to remain behind to prepare for the examinations. So it comes as a shock that the school was burnt again last night, just in a span of a few days. This happens again. So the police and the school administration say they're investigating to find out and establish what exactly happened. And according to the community members around Madera East, where the school is, they were saying, or at least they were giving us their opinions and their views, that they feel that there might be an outside hand at play. Well, they based that on the fact that the students themselves, that is the Form 4s who were left behind to prepare for the examinations, that they, some of them were actually crying, and others even initially reports were that about four had been injured after inhaling fumes while they were trying to put out the fire. So according to the residents themselves, they feel that perhaps there is an outside hand at play in this particular fire. The second time, another dormitory has gone up in flames at Giakai Bay Boys High School. But the initial reports that four students had been admitted at Karatina Hospital, we later established that that was not true. But Akisa, a boy yesterday had been arraigned in court from Giakai Bay Secondary School regarding the initial fire that happened a few days ago. So it is quite a shocker that this is the second time this is happening. And Akisa, in Nyeri County, schools so far have been affected by the fire incidents. We have Watuka Secondary School in Keni and now Yakai Bay Secondary School in Madera East. And there are schools that have already been closed. Just today, Giakanja Boys High School, the boys were sent home due to or following an arrest that occurred. They went on strike and they were told then to go home, perhaps to avoid or to avert further disasters. Other schools that tension has been reported and the boys or students rather sent home, like Mweru Secondary School, the fires did not happen, or rather the students were nabbed right before that happened. In most schools, petrol being found in the dormitories or in the school premises, so an indicator that perhaps the students or whoever it is that is behind these fires, you know, with the petrol being found in the school, then perhaps an indicator of what the plans might have been. Ngoru Secondary School, Dr. Kamundia, a couple of schools in Nyeri County that have been sent home. And Keni, the one that you have mentioned in Kirinyaga County, girls, Keni Girls Secondary School. Yes, a fire was reported in that particular school. Akisa.
Thank you very much for that update from Nyeri County. Carol Nderi is joining us from our Nyeri County offices there with an update on the wave of unrest in Nyeri County and the situation there. As he says, a number of schools have already been closed down, and this is a situation we continue to follow up for you on schools unrest. Nyeri County is not the only one being affected. This looks like a larger problem. And now let's bring in Stephen Chaboy, joining us from our city center studios. He is the national chairman of the NGOs, joining us from our city center studios. Thank you very much for coming into News Desk, Stephen. And the NGOs are some of the stakeholders that have their proposals on this particular situation. What are they?
First of all, we would like to sincerely condemn what is happening in our schools. And as NGOs in this country, we are completely against what is happening. and more so call for immediate action to ensure that what is happening should not happen anymore. As NGOs, we are so against it, and we are saying that initially we had really condemned these incidents happening in our schools, and there is a lot that needs to be really unearthed in terms of what is happening in terms of school unrest, banning of schools by our students is something that we really need to look at as a country.
Well, but part of those who are members of the NGO are definitely parents. And how would you like this exactly to be addressed, this situation?
First of all, this situation, just since it happened recently, though it has been there before, is something that we as stakeholders in this country have to look at critically. Because one, we are saying that why now? Why now? What is it that banning of schools is happening all of a sudden and across the country? What is behind this? Because as stakeholders and particularly as NGOs, we are so much concerned because as we have also been contributing so much in terms of school developments, and even that some of the parents are members of NGOs and also are beneficiaries, or even these schools are also beneficiaries of our work as NGOs in this country, and we are calling for a national dialogue. Because again, this has become a national disaster all of a sudden. Yesterday evening, you have heard that more than five schools were on fire, and we don't know what will happen next. And we are saying that as stakeholders, we should immediately come on table to also try to find solutions. We have heard initially key stakeholders speaking around the same, but it is still happening.
All right.
What is it all of a sudden?
All right, hold on to that thought. A very valid question you have there, Stephen. We will definitely be coming back to you. Stephen Chaboy is the national chairman of the NGOs with proposals definitely on what should be done to curb the wave of unrest in schools. More than 70 schools banned so far, a situation we keep putting our eyes on for you. But for now, let's just... All right. We're just about to take a break from there. All right, Arson in schools, a situation we keep keeping tabs on for you. But for now, let's take a short break. Do not go too far. We still have a lot to land up for you on KTN News Desk.